Greetings. This is Dr. McDaniel at GYN Corner. I'm a board certified obstetrician gynecologist in New York City, and I'm bringing to you all things health related for women. Thank you for joining me at the corner today. And yes, I have what looks like an odd topic today, but it's actually a question that comes in or an issue that patients bring up probably about two or three times a week, and that is itchy bottom. Now, medically, we'd call it anal pruritus. So that's itchy bottom, or the anus is irritated and itchy. That issue or question or concern comes up a few times a week. And most women, when they mention it to me, they'll say, I'm worried, or I think I might have hemorrhoids because I checked out on Dr. Google and it said anal itching can potentially be due to hemorrhoids. And every blue moon, someone will say, oh, the anal itching, I'm worried I have pinworms or something, because I saw also on Google it could be hemorrhoids or pinworms. Now, of course, for pinworms, that's not going to be GYN related. It's going to be a gastroenterologist or GI doctor, because they'll need to take a stool sample, see if there's worms in it. But for GYN, the most common reason for anal itching is going to be one of two entities: either a vaginal discharge that they weren't aware of because it's such a small amount but it's accumulating, or increased sweat moisture. So whenever anyone comes in with anal itching to me, I ask a series of questions, and the questions are involved around either seeing if they've changed their diet. So increased sugars, carbs, breads, alcohol, fruits, those will all potentially increase yeast fungal buildup, either intestinally or vaginally. Then it's to see if maybe they've had a change in their bowel activity, so increased frequency of bowel movement, so loose stools or diarrhea. Sometimes it's just that they're not wiping super well, because a lot of times if they're having increased stool frequency or even constipation and they're just using the paper, toilet paper, it can leave a little bit of stool around the anal canal that has bile salts in it, and the stool itself with bacteria and yeast fungal elements can cause an inflammatory response, and that can cause itching. So I always recommend that instead of using paper towels, they use the baby wipes or adult wipes, because that will clean the bottom really well, much better than just paper towels. And then I also try to find out if maybe they've increased their exercise routine, so now they're sweating more often, or if they're wearing a lot of layers, so pantyhose or leotards or the leggings under regular pants, that it can increase sweat and moisture buildup for some people. And the skin should stay cool and dry. So if you're sweating more often, your skin is staying wet, that's going to cause an inflammatory environment, and that inflammatory response will cause swelling, burning, stinging, itching, and discomfort. Some women don't think they have a vaginal discharge, but if you have a vaginal discharge, it's, you know, the pelvis, the bottom is kind of like a boat. So when you have a little bit of discharge that just slowly but surely just makes its way out of the vagina, it's either going to accumulate at the vaginal introitus, at the vaginal opening, or it's going to accumulate at the two ends of that kind of boat shape. So it's going to accumulate either the introitus at the clitoral hood area or at the anal area. And when it accumulates there, that little tiny moisture builds up throughout the day. Those are the one of the three areas that it's going to cause an inflammatory response, an itching, discomfort, or with sweat, same story. So obviously if they're here in the office, I'm going to do an exam, evaluate, make sure it's nothing more problematic that's causing the itching. And then in order to prevent or potentially to avoid that scenario, they could either obviously change their diet if they're having more sugars, fruits, alcohol, breads, that kind of thing, or they can do the wipes in the bottom, like I said, or they can keep a little bit of thin film of coconut oil, because coconut oil does have mild anti and inflammatory, antibiotic, antifungal effects, and it also can act as a a protective skin barrier from wetness, or Vaseline, or 1% hydrocortisone ointment, the emollient. They'll do the same thing, protective barrier. So wipe or clean with the wet wipes, not wet wipes, but adult bottom wipes or the baby wipes, and then put a thin film of coconut oil, Vaseline, petroleum jelly, or 1% hydrocortisone cream, which you can get over the counter at the drugstore. So I hope that's been helpful information on anal pruritus, which is itchy bottom. Thanks for joining me at GYN Corner. This is Dr. McDaniel. Please hit the like, subscribe, follow buttons if you like the content where I've been presenting. And check us out not just on Facebook, but on YouTube and on all of the podcast platforms. Have a great rest of your day and blessings to you all. Bye.